pitch in for a strike. I don't think Concertina could throw it straight if you asked him to. Everything he's got's moving one way or the other, isn't it?
It is, and obviously makes it tough on the hitter. You see the first pitch fastball there, and but you're right. It's the sink. It's the arm side run. It just makes it extremely difficult.
Well, and you see that pitch right there. That pitch drifted off the plate. I could get you the track man horizontal number on it. Ran down in a way at a negative 11-inch mark. Then he can spin that slider that you saw to the back foot of Slade Wilkes. So you're seeing a ball dart away from you from a left-hander, and then you're also watching a pitch back foot you on that back leg. Really, really difficult.
Yeah, you're exactly right. To a veteran club with some, you know, as Coach Hartlip says, not much experience, but age. You have the older lineup, the older dugout. To me, that's where this comes into play.
Carson Pato takes a strike out of the hand of T.J. Concertina. That's a slider in for a strike, and it's 0-2. They get 1-for-5. Concertina paints the inner half. Really good two-seamer. That's a really difficult pitch to hit.
Yeah, you can see the arm side run there, and Pato knew it. Tip your hat there.
And here's arguably the hottest hitter in the Golden Eagle order up, Slade Wilkes. Wilkes takes one for a strike, 0-1. I used to tell people all the time, I called Nick Sandlin a paper shuffler. As we broadcast, these booths tend to get messy with paper all over them. When Sandlin used to trot in, I used to gather my papers up because the ball game at that point was practically over. No need to keep writing or looking for statistics. And look at Concertina, backdoor slider that catches the back half, 0-2. Concertina's got some stuff, too, now. Former Golden Eagle pitcher. 1-2. My goodness, Concertina spins a slider. Wilkes swings over the top of it. 3 strikeouts for T.J. Concertina. Watch this pitch, Cliff. Back foot slider if I've ever seen one.
And that's on a guy who's seeing the ball in Slade Wilkes better than anybody, really. Yeah.
Prior to this, gets Griffin Everett to chase there. And with the delivery and the style of the breaking ball that he threw there, it really forced Everett almost out of his shoes.
So here's the top of the order and Bryce Matthews. Lead down to 4. It's been as large as 7 for Illinois today. First pitch is a called strike on the outside. Matthews today, a pair of singles, 1 in the first, 1 in the 7th. It's 2-for-4 this afternoon. A 1. Swing and a miss. No balls and 2 strikes, 2 outs. Efrai Cervantes on first. The pitch home. Just misses outside. Everybody on the infield for Illinois took about three or four steps over to their dugout, thinking it was strike three, but Matthews will live to see another pitch. Literally in unison, the pitcher and the four infielders all at once. 1-2, there's the strikeout, a swing and a miss from Matthews, and the inning is now over. Another payoff. Check swing, called strike three regardless. Illinois gets a Sunday victory in Lincoln.
Ernie, in a 1-2 count, and Georgia really does feel like this game's starting to find its groove. It's a fast-paced game and an exciting one to call so far as Tyler Cerny swings and misses. He was way out in front of that one. And Constantina has been doing a great job in relief.
Absolutely nasty, that left-to-right movement right there in the eyes of the hitter.
Constantina, the throw in there for a strike. Constantina's feeling really confident about throwing to that outside part of the plate.
Oh, yeah, his off-speed is cooking right now, and he knows it. Again, confidence is a lot of it. It's very much of a mental game as much as it is a physical game for these pitchers.
Bobby Whalen, an 0-1 count at the plate, fouls that one back, and Constantina delivers strike two.
So he went with the fastball there, and Whalen made contact with it. I'm very curious to see what he does here. You know, everyone in that dugout, in that Hoosier dugout, is talking about that off-speed.
Constantina.
Now he's going to be forced to throw a strike here. He's probably going to go inside, produce weak contact. How about that?
And the crowd is loving it here at Illinois Field. Constantina gets out of a jam and is able to strike out Bobby Whalen.
That was amazing. Second inning in a row.
Illini lead by one here at Illinois Field. Payoff pitch. A swing and a miss. DJ Constantina gets out of the jam for Illinois. Keeps the Illini lead alive. Illinois 4, Michigan State 3, headed to the bottom of the fifth. Round here. And Constantina gets him with that slider. And there's that slider again. It's that righty-righty matchup we've been talking about since Constantina entered the game.
Yeah, it's just so hard to hit those type of sliders because you really have, if it's executed well by the pitcher, you can't pull it. You got to stay inside the baseball and take it the other way. If he's starting it, seems like he's starting it over the plate and it's breaking right off the plate, which is kind of going right around their barrel, missing their barrels a lot. But TJ just doing a really great job being aggressive. So far,
TJ Constantina got Dylan Kark swinging on three straight sliders. So one of the speedier runners as he swings and misses there. The pitch. Got him.
Throws him up right there. Great pitch, great execution.
So we've seen Constantina come in, have two swinging strikeouts, and then he gets Casey Mays looking there.
Now batting number 31, Greg.
Time, and he delivers. And a swing and a miss, strike three. Constantina has retired all four he's faced, a 1-2-3 eighth. We're tied at three, going to the bottom of the eighth.
Bell, Constantina. Just outside. Oh, he thought he had strike three. I think he was continuing to walk towards the dugout. He's also walking towards the plate, so it's tough to tell if he thought he had it or not.
He's got UT Martin a little bit off balance when you throw that frisbee slider with the fastball.
Outside corner, strike three.
Just stay inside the ball, try to poke it over the shortstop's head.
3-2 pitch, swung on and missed, strike three. And Indiana down in order. In the sixth inning, Constantina doing the job out of the pen, gets the strikeout.
It is TJ Constantina.
Tuesday as a graduate transfer has been one of the most reliable arms out of the bullpen for the Illini this season. He's made a team-high 21 appearances and also leads the team in saves. He's with 33 batters in 33.2 innings of work and stranded 20 out of 24 inherited runners. Costantino received his master's in accountancy last week. He's joined today by Mom Cindy and Dad Jim.
How would you describe your experience with Illinois baseball in one word?
I would say special. This is my home to me. This is the home state I'm from. It's a place I've always wanted to end up at, and it's meant a lot to be playing baseball for the University of Illinois this year. And the culture here is awesome. It's always a great time in the clubhouse with the guys, and the coaches are awesome to always be around. It's just a special place to me. To my coaches, I can't thank you enough for the opportunity you've given me to play baseball at the University of Illinois. It's meant a lot to me to play for such a prestigious university, and your help and guidance throughout the year has been impactful to me. To my teammates, it's been a pleasure playing with you guys this last year. I've loved going to war and battle with you guys throughout the season. It's meant a lot to me how welcoming you've been to me, and can't wait to see you guys ball out in the future.
Can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down.